So in today's video we are going to study the clavicle, mainly the osteology part of the clavicle bone. Now see the position of the clavicle. Before starting the clavicle, we have to see the some peculiarities of the clavicle bone. Clavicle does not have any medullary cavity. So it is devoid of medullary cavity. It ossifies mostly in the membrane. It is the only long bone that lies horizontally, and it is subcutaneous throughout. It is the first bone to start ossifying and last bone to complete ossification. It is the only long bone which has two primary centers of ossification. Sometimes it is pierced by the middle supraclavicular nerve. It transmits the weight from the upper limb to the axial skeleton by the lateral one-third through the foraco-clavicular ligament. So it is also known as the modified long bone.
So this is the right side of the clavicle. This is the medial side. This is the lateral side. This is the anterior side. This is the posterior side. Okay. So according to these four things, we are going to study the clavicle bone. So this is the right side of the clavicle. As you know, this is the anterior side, posterior side, medial side or lateral side. So according to this, we are going to study this bone. First of all, we are going to discuss about the shaft. This full is the shaft of the bone, and it has the medial end and the lateral end. First we will discuss about the shaft. If you will divide the bone, if you will see, this is a S-shaped bone. Okay, here curve is there. So we divide into the medial two-third and lateral one-third. Just remember, it has the medial two-third, lateral one-third. First we will discuss about the lateral one-third of the shaft. So lateral one-third, if you will see, it is a flattened above to downward. Okay, it is flat and it has two borders. This is the anterior side, is the anterior border. Just remember this. This is the anterior border. Posterior side is the posterior border. Superior side, you have the superior surface. Inferior side is the inferior surface. If you will see, anterior border is concave forward and gives origin to the deltoid muscle. Posterior border is convex backward and gives insertion to the trapezius muscle. Superior surface, if you will see, it is subcutaneous, so it lies just below the skin. And inferior surface, if you will see, this full is the inferior surface. In the inferior surface, you will see the one tubercle or elevation. This is known as the conoid tubercle, and continuation laterally of the tubercle, you will see this rough area. This is known as the trapezoid ridge. Okay, so conoid tubercle and trapezoid ridge, these both will give attachment to the conoid and trapezoid part of the coracoclavicular ligament. Coracoclavicular ligament. So these are the things we are going to study in the lateral one-third. Now we will discuss about the medial two-third. So medial two-third, if you will see, it is rounded. Okay, medial two-third is the rounded, and it has four surface. Four surface means it has the anterior surface, it has the posterior surface, superior surface and inferior surface. Okay, four surfaces are there. Anterior surface is convex forward. Okay, it is convex forward and it will give origin to the pectoralis major muscle. Okay, so you can say clavicular fiber of the pectoralis major muscle. Posterior surface is convex, it is concave backward. Okay, is concave backward and it is smooth, and it will give origin to the sternohyoid muscle. Okay, so posterior surface, if you see near the medial end, okay, near the medial end, it will give origin to the sternohyoid muscle. Superior surface, if you see, superior surface is rough. Okay, in the medial part, it is rough, and it give origin to the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Okay, it give origin to the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Okay, so this is the clavicular head of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. If you turn toward the inferior side, so this full is the inferior surface. On the inferior surface, what we are going to see, we will see the this impression, this oval shape impression. You can see rough oval shape impression near the medial end, near the medial end. So it will give attachment to the costoclavicular ligament. Costo means costal cartilage, first costal cartilage to the clavicle, costoclavicular ligament. Lateral side, if you see on the lateral half, you see the groove. This is the groove. This is known as the subclavian groove. Okay, this groove, you can see this is the subclavian groove, and it will give attachment to the subclavius muscle. Okay, subclavius muscle, and margin of these grooves will give attachment to the clavipectoral fascia. Also, you should know in this bone, we can see clearly, if you will see, this is the nutrient foramen. Okay, this is the nutrient foramen. It lies lateral to the groove. Now we will see the ends. Ends, as I told you, this is the medial end, this is the lateral end. Okay, medial end, lateral end. Lateral end is flat above to downward. Okay, and it has a facet, okay, articular facet, and it will articulate with the acromion process of the scapula to form the acromioclavicular joint. So this lateral end is also known as the acromial end, because it will attach with the acromion process, okay, to form the acromioclavicular joint. Medial end is also known as the sternal end, and it is quadrangular in shape and articulate with the clavicular notch of the manubrium sterni. Okay, so it will form the sternoclavicular joint on the medial side. Just remember, medial end will form the sternoclavicular joint, lateral end will form the acromioclavicular joint. So last thing, how you will identify the side of the bone, how you will say this is the right side or left side of the bone. Just remember, medial two-third is convex forward and lateral one-third is concave forward. This is the one identification feature. Lateral end is flat above to downward. Medial end is rounded or quadrangular in shape. Superior surface, if you see full superior surface, it has no ridge, no tubercle. Okay, so you can identify the superior surface. Or inferior surface, at the junction of medial two-third and lateral one-third, you will see the conoid tubercle and trapezoid ridge. So it is the inferior side, and also you will see the oval rough impression on the inferior surface. Okay, subclavian groove also on the inferior surface. So you can say this is the right side of the clavicle.